But now technology in the form of air-to-surface vessel radar was beginning to be utilized. By mid-1941, half of Coastal Command's patrol aircraft were thus equipped. Another effective long-range patrol flying boat entered the fight, the American PBY Catalina. One of its primary missions was to destroy surfaced U-boats transiting through the Bay of Biscay. But even long-ranged Catalinas operating from Britain, North America, and Iceland could not provide cover for convoys in the mid-Atlantic. This gap was fully exploited by U-boats using wolf pack tactics, which decimated the convoys. By the end of 1942, losses had doubled to 5.5 million tons, or over 1,000 ships sunk. Gradually, the gap was closed with the introduction and strength of very long-ranged Liberator aircraft. By 1943, the tide of war had turned against the U-boat, so that it was reduced from a predatory wolf to a hunted dog. The Battle of the Atlantic was arguably the single most important one of the war. Had the U-boats won, Britain would not have been able to sustain war against Germany. And leading the fight against the U-boat had been the anti-submarine airplane.